What's up, guys? PK Sparks here. As promised last month, I'm going to be doing these weekly, monthly videos, and I'm very excited to be doing this. I have a lot of things to talk about. Usually, if you guys don't know, these update videos will be just ways for you guys to know what's going on the channel. I know for some reason, everybody won't come to every Mario Kart Mondays live stream. Everybody won't come to every Q&A live stream. Not everybody is following me on Twitter, so they won't be able to hear all the responses to everything I'm doing. So, what I figure would be the best thing is to dedicate a video, one video a month, where not only can I detail for you guys everything that is not only happening, like tell you guys my thoughts on everything, but to also tell you about what is coming on in the future, about things that are going on in playthroughs past, present, and future is what you can get caught up on in these update videos. You guys ask me a lot of questions, and I remember them all. And in these update videos, I will pretty much put it on a public forum so everybody can know exactly what is going on. I love these update videos, and I can't wait to get into it. But one aspect I really want to do for these update videos, let me just pull it up real quick, pull up my itinerary, because I have everything written down that I want to talk about. The first thing I want to get to you guys about is the fact that with these update videos, I want you guys to ask me some questions. Anything you want, if it's anything, don't make it anything generic. Like, don't ask, what's your name? Because that's just asinine and I'm not going to answer it. That's anything, that's something you can ask anywhere. And everybody knows my name. Tell them in the comments what my name is, all right? So don't ask anything like that. But if anything for advice, like, you know, sometimes people ask, what's your, what advice do you have for LPers? I can answer that. Or what kind of equipment do you use? I can answer stuff like that. Something that really does require a fleshed out answer. Not something that's yes or no. This isn't a Q&A live stream. I want to try and be informative. So, if there's anything you really want help with, anything you really want information of, or anything you just want my opinion on, let me know in the comment section below. Post your questions, and yours just may get chosen for September's update video. Now, that was actually the first thing I wanted to talk to you guys about. The second thing is the shirt shop. My initial idea was to have a different design for every playthrough that we do. However, I don't think that's going to be able to happen just because it's pretty freaking expensive to get one icon drawn. I mean, all the icons I have drawn up right now, and you know what's funny? I even have a design that I haven't released yet. I have a few designs that I haven't released yet, but you know, just getting ahead of myself is kind of expensive for me to do, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to do one for every major LP. However, I'm sorry, for every LP. However, for the major ones, definitely. Definitely. I already have my Static Mario, the one jumping up in the warp pipe to save the day. I'm going to give you guys a sneak peek. Of something, but you know what? That's going to be for the end of the video, so stay tuned to the end so you guys can find out the little sneak peek that I have sitting right here on my desk. But anyway, it's kind of hard for me to get those designs up, and especially since Spreadshirt is literally denying my designs. They're telling me that Black Mario is copyright because it's clearly Mario from Nintendo. No, it's not Mario from Nintendo. It is PK Sparks. Black Mario. Do you see the fitted? They don't understand. But, you know, I guess they're just being, like, extremely legal about it. I mean, since when is a hat in overalls copyrighted? I'm black. I have a mustache. You see this? Do you see this mustache I have? I have a mustache. I don't understand why they're denying Black Mario, but every time I upload a design, they shoot it down. And it's really irritating. And it's hard for me to get shirts up because I told you guys I was going to update it every single month. However, it's not that easy. But I do have new stuff coming. As a matter of fact, I already have a design slated for release in September. But you guys won't find out about that until anytime soon. But long story short, I want to remind you guys that my t-shirt shop is not dead. I still remember it, and people are still ordering shirts. As a matter of fact, I got one today where somebody ordered the Legend of Black Mario, you know, the blade wielding Black Mario, which is really freaking awesome. I'm glad. I love seeing the email when you guys grab a shirt. It's just there for you guys if you want to represent the channel, if you want some merchandise. Like I said, you guys wanted it, so for 50K, I opened it, and it's been fruitful. So thank you guys for your love and support. If you guys want, it will be linked in the description below. PKSparks.Spreadshirt.com. We have Black Mario jumping out the warp pipe to save. You know what? You guys have seen the ads. Y'all have seen the ads on every live stream I have. So you guys don't need it. But pretty much, just check it out. Link in the description below. Mario Kart Mondays. That was a big, You guys remember last summer, last update video, I said I was worried about the channel. And I still am to an extent, but you know what? I feel as though everything I went through this summer has just been a more of a transitional period. Things are starting to change, and I just gotta roll with the punches. Now, you guys pretty much demanded Mario Kart Weekend Track Grand Prix, and I heard your cries. I brought it back with Season 2. As of this recording, I am recording this on August 7th, 2014. I'm gonna go to check the video right now. Checking the video. Where's it at? Alright. As of this moment, it has 11,000. 11,000 views and almost 1,700 likes. My initial goal was 2,000, like 2,000 overall. I wasn't expecting that right now, but 2,000 likes overall is what I anticipated for that. Another thing I wanted was 800 within that first day. I know we're shooting for the dark, but I figured like with the popularity of Mario Kart Wii Custom Tracks on the channel, I felt as though shooting for 800 wasn't asking for too much. We got to 1,200, close to 1,300. We destroyed that. That lets me know that Custom Tracks is here. You guys love Season 2. You love the layout we came out with. You love the face cam. You love the layout entirely. You love everything about it. And that lets me know, like I said, that's literally my best video this entire summer. Insane. Now, I do gotta make a request. Matter of fact, you know what? Actually, that reminds me, I'm gonna make a note about that right now. You know what? Actually, I'm gonna end that. About LPs and LPers. Alright, not POers. Police officers, wow. I don't care about no police. We don't mess with these pigs! Unless we transform to the pigs, like in Twilight Town in Chapter 4 of Paper Mario 1000 Year Door. But that's a story for another time. But anyway, I'm gonna add that to the end. After I talk about the actual channel, I'll bring that up. But I know you guys love the custom tracks. As such, expect it every single Monday for Mario Kart Mondays, 3:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And as long as you guys comment, as long as you guys take part in the playthrough, so long as you guys hit that like button, not only to support the playthrough and the series, but to support the channel overall, it will stay. And it will be here for a long time to come. Especially since we still have 53 cups left to do. Woo! We have a while! A long while. We have a year, a little over a year until Custom Tracks comes full circle. So we'll be fine for quite a while, alright? No worry about that. Especially, what if I miss a day? If I miss a day, that means we got an extra week later on. It's like summer school. Like, you know how you got winter break? So you miss a couple days in the winter, they get tagged on to the end. In school, it sucks because you want summertime. But in this instance, it's like, yeah, we get an extra week later on. Woo! Like, so you know that more is coming, and you get, it's awesome. But anyway, so that's about the custom tracks. Mario Kart Mondays overall. I need to explain this because a lot of people don't understand the idea behind the Mario Kart 8 tournaments. First of all, it is a series. Have you ever noticed how in the description, in the title, it always says S1E and the number 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1? That's an episode. It's literally a season. Think of it like your favorite TV show. Your TV show will run for 13, 20 episodes, something like that, and then it'll be a new season. That is essentially what I want to do with the Mario Kart 8 the Mario Kart 8 tournament series. So, the first season is summer long. It has been summer long every single Monday, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. For 2 hours, we were raced from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. And then the winners got invited to a Victor's Invitational. Big, okay? And that's how it's going to work. That's how it was working. Now, Season 2 is going to bring about a lot of changes. This is more so because everyone will be going back to school if they aren't back to school already. Because I know that it is August and some kids go back to school in August. I know definitely in South Carolina, is where, you know, a place where they go back to school early. So, these are the changes that are coming to the Mario Kart 8 Tournament Series, Season 2. This will probably change next summer, but one will find out. Now, first of all, the biggest change is the fact that the Mario Kart Mondays Tournament Series got sponsored. I told you guys I was aiming for that sponsorship. It took a while, literally almost all summer, but I got it done. I am now sponsored by the Elgato gaming. Literally, the capture card that I use... Okay. The capture card that I use to record all my videos is what I'm sponsored by. This is big for two reasons. One, they will provide me with the Elgato capture card every single month to give away. To give away! I get to give away the very best capture card that I have ever had the pleasure of using for you guys to use so that you can record your own 1080p HD quality videos, 60 frames per second, and upload them to YouTube. Now, the reason why that's important is because now I can make the second move. Mario Kart Mondays will now go from like 3 months or whatever to being only 4 episodes long per season, but they will be monthly. I can give one away, one per month. So, this is how it's going to go. In season 2, the tournaments will be cut down to an hour. Once again, this is because people are going to be in school, especially on Mondays. As such, I want to take that into consideration. I'm not changing the time. You know what? Should I change the time? You know what? Maybe I should. Let me know in the comment section below. Should I push back the time to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time? Or should I keep it at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time? It's going to be an hour regardless, but I need to know, should I change the time to 5 p.m.? Would that be better for you guys? I need a, you know what? I'll make a straw poll. I'm using that one for, I'm using that one for straw polls, but I'm going to add it anyway. Straw poll. What is it? Straw poll. Should Mario Kart Monday tournaments move to 5 p.m. or stay at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time? Alright, so this straw poll will be in the description. I'll make sure to add it. And make sure you guys leave your vote on that, because that will that will let me know how we do for season 2. And I need to know ASAP. I need some water. I've been recording all day. But I need your answers ASAP, because there's literally less than 2 weeks until season 2 begins. So that's the thing. But what was I saying? Right. It's going to be for an hour long. And also, for season 2, I'm going to change the items. I'm going to change it back to all items instead of frantic to see if people can get a better chance. Because items can be a little unfair, especially at the very end. Because you can not get a good item and then someone else will get like an amazing item. It's just like, what the heck? Granted, I understand that that is the idea of frantic items. But, but it's still just convoluted and I wish that I could change that. So, I'm going to attempt to change that. So like I said, I'm going to change it to all items. Another thing is that it's going to be monthly, and this is how it's going to go. The first race, the first episode of the season, I will accept the first 4 winners. The second episode, I will accept the first 4 winners. The third episode, I will accept the first 3 winners. The reason why there can only be 11 winners is because I need to be in the race as well so that I can live stream it. If I'm not in the race, I can't live stream it. The Victor's Invitational Tournaments will always be 16 races. 16 random races. We don't know what they're going to be. People can pick whatever track they want. And whoever wins the best out of 16 races will be the winner. And that winner will earn themselves an Elgato Game Capture HD. It's going to be powerful, and I can't wait. I'm really glad that I'm sponsored by them, because I could do this. Like, I can't tell you guys enough. Don't think that because I'm sponsoring them, they're sponsoring me, that this is why I'm saying this. I went to them for their sponsorship because I think they make amazing quality content, devices. Like I said, I have gone through a Dazzle. I have gone through a Blackmagic. I have gone through the HD PVR 1 and 2. Literally, nothing comes close than the Elgato. Just the best capture card I ever had. And just the fact that I can now give these out to you guys just for participating in the tournament. Yes! So, that's a big thing. That's a huge thing. So, one more time to recap. I'm going to say real quick fire. Like, Mario Kart 8 moving to either... It might move to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, depending on how you guys vote on the straw poll in the description below. It will be moved to an hour long, and the tournaments will be all items for season 2 instead of frantic items. I will accept for the first episode of season 2, I will accept the first 4 winners. For the second episode, I will accept the first 4 winners. The third episode, I will accept the first 3 winners. And then the fourth episode will be the Victor's Invitational Tournament. That's 4 weeks in a month. That's just enough to get it out there. And after that's done, the next month, we recycle it. It moves fast. Everyone can get an opportunity. We give away more Elgato's because I can do it once a month. So I can give away more of those for you guys. And it's just a way, and even if it's just more convenient for everybody else if I just move it to an hour. So that's the decision I made. That's how season 2 is going to rock out. Hope you guys enjoy that. Let me know your opinions on that in the description below. Whew! Now, upcoming LPs. If everything went well, Mario Party 8 should have gone up already. What'd you guys think? Now, if it didn't go up yet, it will go up. I already have the entire thing recorded. I had such a blast recording it. I already have the single player done, and I had the first board for multiplayer completed. It's so much fun. It's a great game, and I had a lot of fun. Will you guys see it? I can't believe what happened. I cannot believe what happened. You guys know that Mario Party is a luck-based game. I had the worst luck. Piece two together. It was such a blast. I'm getting excited. I got amped. I got caught up into it. I fell out my chair. That's how hype it was. So that's starting very soon, and I can't wait. I got another playthrough. No, never mind. You guys don't wait for that. By the way, as a reminder, don't forget, I have something to show you guys after I get done discussing everything. So stay tuned to the very end. But, I have playthroughs coming. In the idea of upcoming LPs, Mario Party's a thing. That's underway. I have something else. First of all, I'm starting to not really wanting to express my upcoming LPs just because I want that surprise. I love that surprise factor. I want to just drop the bomb. You know, I don't want to give any warning, any information or anything. I just want to drop it. Just let y'all get hyped, like, what the heck? Similar to what I did with the Sonic Adventure 2 versus with Sacred Fire Negro, that cheating bastard. But you guys came out, you guys love that, you watch, you view, and that's all I want. So you guys are here, thank y'all for that, and I want to keep doing that. So if it's an old game, I'm not going to mention it, alright? However, if it's a new game, I'll let you guys know if it will be on the channel. As such, Hyrule Warriors will be on the channel. Super Smash Bros. 3DS will be on the channel. Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire will be on the channel. Super Smash Bros. For the Wii U will be on the channel. Mario Maker will be on the channel. What's that other game? What's another game that's coming out? I can't think of it. Oh, it's bugging me. I can't think of it. There's another game. It's bogging my mind. But pretty much, I have brand new games to do every single month until the end of the year. We're good on that account. Now, regarding unfinished LPs, Super Mario All-Stars will continue. Will actually not so much continue, but it will be redone. I don't have a time, and it will not happen this year. It will not happen this year. However, next year, and I mean early next year, I don't know if you guys noticed this, but every time a year comes around, I start a brand new LP. 2 years ago, I believe it was Diddy Kong Racing or Donkey Kong. I believe it was Diddy Kong Racing. It had to be Diddy Kong Racing. And that was 2012. It was Diddy Kong Racing and Donkey Kong 64. I forget what it was last year, and this year it was the Wonderful 101. So who knows, maybe January 1st can bring back the revival of the Super Mario All-Stars Versus. But that will get done, and I hope you guys look forward to that. Fire Emblem Awakening. Now this one has a story. The reason why Fire Emblem Awakening had to continue is because when I first began that game, it was on my PC that wasn't as powerful as, you know, this one is. This one is my baby. This one renders like a mother. I love this thing. This is the mother of all biscuit PCs. Seriously, it's just it's amazing. I love it. I unplug it and cuddle with it at night. Like it lights up. It's so I love it. Anyway. I got this from CM Punk. Like he always does this when he was in the ring, and I got it from him. But anyway, I stopped doing that game because it would take me on my old PC 6 hours. All right. Well, first of all, let me put this in perspective. In the later chapters, it would take me a while on hard mode to beat those stages just because they were so difficult. It took a lot of thinking, a lot of strategy, and it wasn't something you could just kind of speed through, because if you went in there blindly, just kind of just like, well, this should work, it wouldn't work, okay? It would not work, and you would just get bodied. So I had to take my thought. If you guys watched all the way up to chapter 21, you know what I mean. Now, the reason why I didn't continue is because it would get upwards to like an hour, hour and a half long. I know one episode, yeah, was like an hour, hour and a half long. It was so freaking long. And then it would take me like 6 or 7 hours to render. With that said, it was not getting as many views as my other content. I more so decided to scrap it because not a lot of people were watching it. But I feel as though as my sub count grew, so did the interest in Fire Emblem Awakening. I don't know if I actually garnered an audience that would love that game, but let me know in the comment section below. Just say, let me know full force if you want Fire Emblem. I want you guys to make it easy for me. Just type Fire Emblem Awakening, please, if you want more Fire Emblem. Now, I will not continue it this year because this year is already scheduled with LPs. However, it's good to know what you guys want so I can, you know, consider it for the future. I will not do it right now simply because the fact that Shady Penguin just began his LP on his side channel, Shady Side Gaming. So, it will not happen this year. It won't happen even for a while. Even though I only have 4 chapters left, he has the game now. I had my chance and I let it go. So, it's all on him now. Good luck to him. I'm watching his LP. As a matter of fact, I told him I demand to be in for chapter 9. He hasn't played the game yet, but if you guys watched it, you know what chapter 9 is. And I'm going to be there. I'm going to be there and watch it vicariously through him. And I want to feel his emotions when it's going to be so amazing. So go show him love. Go comment on his video. Tell him I sent you. And wish him luck on his playthrough because he's playing on classic mode. He is going to need it. But Fire Emblem will not continue anytime soon. Now, Tales of Symphonia. Another canceled LP. I tried many ways to do that game. I have tried live streaming it. I have tried the original LP of it. I tried the HD LP of it when it first came out for the hype. That didn't work. I tried getting you guys in, but you know what? The majority of my audience just isn't interested in Tales of Symphonia. And you know what? In all honesty, I don't want to do a recorded LP of it and a live stream LP. It just wasn't working. I thought a live stream LP was like my best shot at it, but it just wasn't working. I know people were interested, but in idea for my channel, I need to make sure that when I play a game, it's for the majority. I know it sucks, because I love Tales of Symphonia, but, so I'm in the same boat as you if you enjoyed that LP, but, I mean, you gotta be fair, and I don't know who you are, but get blocked. Okay. Anyway, I don't know, yeah, it's just how it's going to be. So, there will not be a Tales of LP on the channel ever. I'm going to rethink if I do any more RPGs. I think the only other RPG I can do right now, I would do right now, is Mario and Luigi Dream Team. Which, you know, may come sooner or later. I've had graphics for years for that LP. So, it's going to be interesting to see if I can rock out with that. But, like I said, it's all about what you guys want. And I try to cater to the majority, as always. I do things for the minority as well, don't get me wrong. I try to entertain everybody. But, you know, it's just the best way, just the best route. So, you know, at my behest. I think that's the right word. Did I use that word right? Behest? Let me look it up. Behest. A person's orders or command. Nope, that's not the right word. That's not at my command. At your behest. Just by, you know, your lack of interest in LP, it will not continue. And I'm sorry about that, but just how it works sometimes. I already touched on upcoming LPs. Now, So I think I pretty much discovered, I pretty much went over everything that's going on in the channel. Decent, I love that. So, now the question comes, well, first of all, I do have something to say, something that's been on my mind, something I wanted to talk to you guys about. Before we get into that, I want to remind you guys of two things. One, stay tuned to the very end, because I have something right here on my desk to show you guys. And I mean, I think you guys are going to like it. Let me just pull my webcam back up so I can make sure I'm still recording. Everything's going right. My room is a mess. Holy crap. Like, I got a hard drive over there, and I got my bag of recycling right there. And my dresser drawer recently broke because my cat tried to get in there. And I don't know what he was doing, but he just broke the door down. Like, you guys can probably see the holes right there. That's where it unhinged from, and now it's just broken. So, I got to buy a whole new... I could just, like, get those little things that... It's like a little... plugs, you could say, that you put a screw in to make it so it can fit more in a hole that's become worn out. But I'd much rather just buy a new bedroom set because I need one anyway. And then I got my new computer monitor over there. I need to clean up my room. Good lord, look at this. I got my Wii U box out there, my box of I'm a mess. But this is the room of someone who works. Like, when you're working all the time, you ain't got time to be cleaning. Screw that. Wait for your mom or girlfriend or wife to come in. They got that. Well, I mean, unless they working too. If they working, then your house is gonna be kind of a mess. But you're making money though. Hey. Okay. Anyway. 301. Anyway. I wanted to talk to you guys about two things. One, this is very important. It's something that's been on my mind. When it comes to the LP community, it's almost impossible to go to one YouTuber for one game, you know? Example, how I've been known, how I wanted to get the tag on out there, the pinnacle of Mario piece, and thanks to social media, that has become a thing. People call me the pinnacle all the time, and that's great. The reason why I wanted that to be a thing is because I want people to come to me. I want them to think of, you know, when a Mario game gets done, who has the best one? The pinnacle of Mario piece. That's my goal. I always aim to deliver the very best Mario playthroughs. It's just how I am. I love the series and I want to treat it right. So I want to make sure I deliver the very best playthrough of all time. The most informative, the most exciting, the most interesting, the most interactive. That's my whole thing when it comes to YouTube. I want to be interactive with you guys. I want to make sure I deliver interactive playthroughs, and especially with Mario. That's why the moniker came about, and that's a title that I hope to live up to. But at the same time, you shouldn't go to an LPer, especially in today's community, for a certain game. Because at this point, every game has been done. Every game has been done. You should go to an LPer, not for the content they create, but for them. You go there because you want to interact with that content creator, that LPer in this case. I don't think it works with like comedy creators or whatnot. You can subscribe to them for comedy, that's all that. But when it comes to LPers, you want to subscribe to them and watch their content for them, to be entertained by them, to hear about their life experiences, to see their experiences in a playthrough, not for the game itself. I feel as though the game itself should not matter so much as it is. Like, think of it like this. I think of you guys as my friends. And I want to make sure that when we hang out together, we all enjoy what's going on. So you're not going to go play a game with your friends and say, hey, let's play Monopoly, when they don't care about playing Monopoly. But at the same time, you do it because you want to be there with your friend. You know, it's all about enjoying things together. And that's why I feel as though the direction of the LP community needs to go into. So as a viewer, you should really go to content creators of LPers, for them, and just enjoy a game with them. That's why you should always suggest things, suggest games, suggest ideas, suggest live stream. That's why live stream is so important, at least to me, because I love interacting with you guys. I just did a Mario Kart 7 live stream because you guys wanted it. You showed your support for Mario Kart Mondays last week on August 4th. And so I delivered. Because you guys helped me, I delivered you guys. We all entertained each other and you guys enjoyed Mario Kart 7. I don't really enjoy Mario Kart 7, but I did it because I wanted to interact with you guys. So long story short, what I'm saying is, remember the LPer, not the game. The game is just a martyr. It's a reason to meet up. But it's all about the experiences you share with that YouTuber that I think is really important, and the direction that the LP community needs to go into coming forward. That's my new idea, and that's what I'm going to try to embrace. As such, I promise that every LP I do, I will find some way for you to have a part of the LP, such as with Mario Party 8, you chose my character for the single player playthrough. Cannot believe it, and just wait until you see that. I want to continue doing elements like that, such as, you know, like Pokemon 8. I love Egglocks for the reason that everyone who sends in an egg has an investment in the playthrough, especially if your egg gets picked. If a Pokemon dies, everyone feels that pain. If a Pokemon succeeds, everyone feels that triumph. I love Egglocks for that reason, and that's why I hope to do one in the future. I don't know when, like I said, I'm so plant, like, bummed out with plans or whatnot, but I want to do an Egglock in the future. Might, like I said, it might be sometime next year, but expect something soon. But that's my idea about LPers, and that's what I wanted to talk about earlier. That's just what I wanted to speak about in the LP community. And if you agree, if you disagree, or whatever, let me know in the comment section below. Now, I told you guys I had something special to show you guys. But we're not at the end of the video yet. We have to answer some of your questions. Now, this is the only time I'm going to do this. From now on, I want you to let me know your questions in the comment section below. And a month from now, or next month, I will come back to the video, I will scan the comment section, I will find 3 to 5 good questions, and I will answer them. Alright? And I'm going to, you know, take screenshots and whatnot. But for now, I'm going to go on Twitter right now. I tweeted out earlier that I'm going to be answering questions from Twitter. And holy crap, I have over 70. Oh my God. Okay. Well, let's get started. What was your first? At Jennifer Virgo asks, what was your first game in the Mario or Pokemon and Pokemon franchise? The first game I played in the Mario franchise was, by the way, this is going to be a Q&A, so I'm not going to be answering all questions like this. I'm going to scan it real quick, actually. But our answers are already read it out. The first one I played was Super Mario Brothers / Duck Hunt for the NES. And the first Pokemon game I played was Pokemon Blue. I remember my friend had it, and he had a Sand Slash that wasn't listening to him. I felt that to be hilarious. But anyway, let's go on to scan it. My ear is hurting. God. What Let's Plays are you going to do for the fall? The only ones planned so far is Super Smash Brothers 3DS. And oh yeah, a Luigi Mansion playthrough for Halloween. Gotta do that. So there you go. That's your answer right there. Who asked that? For the fall. Alexis C. Cassidy asked that. Okay, let me scan down. Oh, Official Views asked, when you first started YouTubing, did you ever think you would make it this far? The fact that I have 70,000 subscribers is mind-blowing. I always try to compare it like this. Imagine being on stage and there are 70,000 people watching you. Can you even fathom that? It's just like, people come for you. And especially, I mean, if you guys saw my self-esteem video, you kind of know how I feel about this. The fact that I came from that past and now I'm here, no. I started YouTube, I still do YouTube because I just enjoy it. I love it, I love the interaction. That's my favorite part about YouTube, is that I love the interaction. But, okay, I'll just make sure I was still recording, because last time I was recording, and I cut out, and it was just bad. Oh my, I'm at 34 minutes recording, holy crap! Okay, but yeah, no. And I just try to please everybody, because you guys are giving me so much, more than I can express, more than I can let know, but you guys are giving me a lot, and I promise you, above all else, you're first. I promise you that. Let's see, will you make another channel for other LPs that are not Mario related, like PC games? I've been thinking about that, just because I have a bigger variety of games I play that more so that this channel allows the hotness. So I might go back to PK Sparks for that, but it's not anything I'm really contemplating right now. I don't want to do too much. I feel like if I'm doing too many games and recording and worrying about thumbnails and whatnot, I'll get too weighed down with responsibilities. And I don't want that to happen, because then it's going to start feeling like a job, more so than, you know, having fun, the entertainment. I feel as though entertainment should always be fun. Like, if I'm not having fun doing it, you won't have fun watching it, and that's just ugly. So I don't think I'm going to do that anytime soon, but who knows? I have no immediate plans for it, but I'm not against the idea if I can make it happen. Who asked that? That was Epic Gamer Dude 54. Okay. How tall are you? I am 5'5". Brian Bushi. Okay. Who's your favorite Sonic character? Shadow. Definitely Shadow. Let me find another good question. Nintendo Dakota asks, when is another Versus going to appear on our channel? That I cannot say. I don't know. I do not know. Although things are in the works. I'm always talking to people that have ideas. But I don't know when the next Versus is going up. Just gotta wait and see. I won't know, but when I do, you'll be the first to know. PK, can you put Twitch streams on YouTube? See, I need to start doing that. I do need to start doing that. And the Mario Kart 7 live stream I had today, I want to throw up on YouTube. You just got to give me a few, but I definitely want to start doing that. I need to. So, yes. Spender the Hotness. Yes, I will start doing that. Are you getting both remakes for a fourth gen? Fourth gen isn't even a thing for remakes yet. Will you ever call a truce with the Dreaded Train? Never. What is the first game you ever 100%ed? How did it feel to beat a game 100%ed? The first game I ever 100%ed. I want to say Super Mario 64, because like I said, that game is my favorite, and I have so many memories of that game. It's my baby. It literally is my baby, and I love that game and all incarnations of it. So I think that was the first game I ever 100%ed, and I felt so good. I mean, I've 100%ed it so, how many times? I can't tell, and I could go back and play that game again and enjoy myself. Super Mario 64 is just one of the best games of all time. Literally, the best games of all time. Alright, so who has that? That was Flaming Shy Guy. Let me see. What's been going on? That's a good one. Have you ever had a slogan for each year? For example, 2013 was the year to make it splash. 2014 is the year to beast and feast. I don't know what that means, but I've never had a slogan. I've had goals, but then I gotta have goals all the time. So I don't know if that counts as a yearly thing. No, I actually scratched that. My goal this year actually was to get my own place, to get my own car, and to get back into the Smash community. I am making strides to get back to the Smash community. However, I really did slip on getting my license and get my own place. But get my own place, that's a situation for another time. That's a whole personal matter, which is the reason why that's been delayed. I have been trying for that. But my own car, I just haven't been going to the DMV to get my permit. I've been slipping. That's my mistake. And I'm working towards getting ahead on YouTube so I can have the time to just go out the house and just get that done. Who asked that? CBJ2K14 asked that. And here's the last question. The Stealing Absol said, how did you become a part of Lumios? I was asked. Alright, so I think that's a really good time, a really good way to just end the stream off. So thank you all for coming out here. If you enjoyed this video, hit that thumbs up button for me. If you guys want to see more update videos in the future, like I said, these are just pit stops for you guys to just catch up on the channel, know everything that's going on about every single series. And once again, if you have any questions you want to know, you want my opinion on, or you want some information on, you want some help on, leave it in the comment section below. Next month, I'll pick 3 to 5 questions and I will give you guys the best answer I can possibly give. But one more time, thank you all for watching. Stay hot, guys, and I'll see y'all next month for another update. I'm back. I'm sorry. I almost forgot, but literally, I stopped the video, and I'm like, wait a minute. I looked down, I'm like, oh, snap. Okay. At PAX Prime, I got something. It was kind of mandatory for me to go. But I had to get something, and you know what? I'm so freaking glad I got this. And if I have the opportunity to meet any of you guys, expect to get one of these. At PAX Prime, I got business cards. Check that out. Come on, focus. There we go. Check that out. Just look at that. It's my design, my Pandemonium art with the powerful background. You got Toad and Goomba back there. It's so good. And wait, wait to see the back. Boom! Everything on there. Well, actually, yeah, I noticed that the word Die Hotness was spelled wrong. It's missing the T, but you know what? It's okay. The Pinnacle of Mario LPs has my Twitch, has my Twitter, has my Facebook, my Google Plus, my Spreadshirt, and of course, my YouTube at the very top. The very top, coming out the box. That's so decent. This was made by Bulbasaurus. The great Bulbasaurus, the G. What is his YouTube name? It will be linked in the description below. But he made this for me, and I'm not the only one that got something like this. This amazing. It's not my business to actually say, but I'm not the only one who got something like this. But it's freaking amazing, and I will be giving these away at PAX Prime. So if you're going to PAX Prime, come up to me. Best believe you're getting one of these. I'm going to be bringing about 500 with me, 500 of these. And you can get one. I only have 1,000. I think that after every 1,000 I give out, I'm gonna get a new design. So these are gonna be like collector's edition. So if you get one, make sure you keep it. These are powerful. I'm so happy that I feel official with this. I feel so freaking official. Woo! But yeah, that was a big surprise. I couldn't wait. So everyone who stayed to the end, you guys got to see this. Thank y'all. And one more time, see y'all next time.